Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Good morning, dear student. In today's session, we are going to start our new chapter, chapter number 6, Retirement, Death of a Partner. Okay, first we are going to start with introduction of the chapter. Retirement of partners means retiring as a partner from a firm. As per Indian Partnership Act 1932, when a partner retires from a firm for any reason or a partner dies, the partnership ends, but the firm is not dissolved. It means due to any reason, if any partner retires or any partner dies, the partnership ends, but the partnership firm is not dissolved. Okay, remaining partners can continue the firm and its business. For this purpose, necessary accounting treatments of retirements are required. Okay, in this situation, a partnership is reconstructed. Okay, now second point is circumstances of retirement of a partner. The circumstances of retirement of a partner can be divided into two parts. First part is as per Indian Partnership Act, and second one is a voluntary retirement of a partner due to his personal reasons. Okay, now first we are going to learn about first reason as per Indian Partnership Act. Okay, as per Indian Partnership Act, partner can retire from the firm due to any following reasons. A first reason is unanimously. Any partner can retire by unanimous consent of all partners. Okay, second point is by notice. A partner has right to retire from the firm by giving notice to other partners in writing, indicating his intention of retirement from the firm. Next point is, third one is by contract. Any partner can retire as per the condition of partnership deed, as per the contract. Okay, now next point is insolvency. A partnership of any partner ends from the date from which he is declared insolvent. Okay, next point is a death of a partner. Partnership ends automatically due to the death of a partner. It means if any partner dies, okay, the partnership ends automatically. Okay, now next point is expulsion by other partners. Subject to provision in partnership deed, a partner can be expelled by other partner. Okay, now we are going to learn about a voluntary retirement of a partner due to his personal reasons. A partner can decide to retire from the partnership due to his personal reasons. Okay, an active partner is required to give public notice regarding his retirement. It means any partner is actively participating in the partnership firm, a dead partner is required to give public notice regarding his retirement. Otherwise, he is responsible for the liabilities towards third parties arising from the activities after his retirement. Okay, now our next point is important accounting aspects and accounting treatments. Okay, following accounting aspects and accounting treatments are required to be taken into consideration when on the date of retirement a partner retires or dies and remaining partners decide to continue the business of the firm. Fine. First point is calculation of new profit loss sharing ratio and calculation of gaining share of continuing partner. Okay. Next point is valuation of goodwill and its accounting treatment. Okay. And next point is after that a revaluation of assets and liability. Okay. Next point is a distribution of accumulated reserves and balance of undistributed profit and losses. Okay. Then next point is determination of amount payable to the retiring or deceased partner. Fine. And the last one is payment of amount due to the retiring or deceased partner. Okay. In today's session, we have learned about circumstances of retirement of partners, important accounting aspects and accounting treatments, and introduction of the partner. Okay. Next session, we are going to continue our chapter. Goodbye. Take care, all of you.